Okay, so we're standing in a forest here that's about 150 years old, and it regenerated after a wildfire. So it's roughly even aged, and it's made up of mainly Douglas fir, western hemlock, and western red cedar. And it's been relatively undisturbed for about 150 years. And so what you tend to find is that most of it has still a very closed canopy. But over time, there are different sorts of disturbances, and they're happening at various scales. And we're standing beside a patch, or a gap, I should call it, where trees have been dying. And they've been dying relatively recently in the lifetime of this stand. So right here I'm standing beside a western hemlock snag. So a snag is a standing dead tree. And there are others around me and behind me. And they've been dying over time. This one's fairly recent. And when I look at it, I see that it's broken off higher up, and it has a couple of fungal fruiting bodies in it. And we know from experience that this particular type of small-scale disturbance is fairly common in this forest type at this age. And what happens is a fungus can occur just in scattered locations that's pathogenic and will attack certain weak trees. And this one here is most likely one that's called Fomatopsis pinicola, and it tends to just kill small groups of trees fairly randomly scattered across the forest. And what you have happening now is that because this gap has been forming, you have light coming through, and it's reaching down through the canopy and into the understory, and you can see that understory shrubs have really been flourishing. And there is even some understory regeneration that's now starting to release a little bit. So I see big leaf maple and western hemlock, and there are other shrubs and small trees that are starting to occupy this gap. They're taking advantage of the growing space and the resources and the light that's become available.